Hello everyone, today's topic is 28 and today I am going to discuss aromaticity and aromatic character. So the term aromaticity is having very broad meaning, and those compounds which are aromatic, they have very special type of characteristic. For example, benzene is very common type of aromatic compound, and benzenes, they have high unsaturation, means presence of double bond. So they are supposed to undergo addition reaction, but they are not going to under reaction, I mean addition reaction, rather than they prefer to undergo substitution reaction. And the substitution reaction, the characteristic of substitution reaction is that the aliphatic or alicyclic compounds with saturation, with single bond, saturated compounds, they are supposed to undergo substitution reaction. But here the condition is different. And secondly, if benzene ring is having high level of unsaturation, means double bond, it means that benzene should be very much unstable, rather than benzene is very stable compounds. So these are very, very special characteristic of aromatic compounds. First, they contain double bond and they undergo substitution. Second, they contain double bond and they are very stable, rather than they should have been very much unstable. So actually in benzene, it is not pure double bond. Rather than the pi electrons are delocalized, and all six carbon atoms are having those electrons which are delocalized rather than the fixed position. So here I have already given you that the benzene and its derivatives exhibits properties which are altogether different from those of aliphatic and alicyclic compounds. Such compounds are known as aromatic compounds. Some important characteristics of aromatic compounds. First one is, the aromatic compounds show a high degree of unsaturation, but they don't undergo addition reaction, shown by aliphatic unsaturated compounds. Instead, they prefer substitution reaction. The second point, the term aromaticity can be concluded by the ability of aromatic compounds to exhibit the extra stability, very much stable, and resistance to addition reaction in spite of having double bonds. But we are saying double bond, exactly they are not pure double bonds. Like, so in continuation of aromaticity, now I have already explained to you that they prefer substitution in spite of the fact that they have double bond and they are very stable. Now the other points are there. The Huckel in 1931 gave his aromaticity rule, that is called Huckel rule, and unless the compound they follow Huckel rule, they cannot be aromatic compounds. And his rule is 4N plus 2. That rule must be followed by pi electrons, and if they pi electrons, they don't have that sextet rule, that is called sextet, 2N plus 2 and N may be 0, 1, 2, 3. So Huckel rule is a must. And secondly, there must be conjugation, and pi electron conjugation is also very important, means single, double, and the impact of pi electron should be to all carbon atom, and it must be delocalized in the ring system. That why it is called aromaticity. And delocalization of pi electron is not the only condition to be aromatic, unless it is following the Huckel rule. So what we are saying, the Huckel rule in 1931, he gave the rule for aromaticity, 2N plus 2, pi electrons, number can be 0, 1, 2, 3, etc., is known as Huckel rule. Delocalization of pi electrons is not the only condition for compound to be aromatic. If the organic compounds which do not have 4N plus 2 pi electrons will not be aromatic. And then the molecule exhibit aromaticity must have flat structure, is very important. And the other one is that it should have cyclic cloud of delocalized pi electrons above and below the plane of the molecule. And the last given is there must be conjugated pi electrons system, and the pi electrons must belong to all carbon atoms of the cyclic system. In continuation of resonance, so I have already told you that for a compound to have resonance, there must be conjugated pi bond. So for example, if you take benzene, in the case of benzene, generally we are writing like this, and this one, they are pi electrons and they are sigma electrons. But these pi electrons, what we are showing, they are not original or 100% double bond. Rather than they are delocalized, and in that delocalization we are getting this delocalized pi electron, and this delocalized pi electron is having all six carbons are influenced, are affected by this delocalization, and they have equal share of this pi electron. That's why in the case of benzene, there is not pure covalent bond, and these electrons are moving inside the ring system or cyclic system, and that is the reason. That's why neither it is pure single bond nor it is pure double bond, in between, hybrid structure. And because of that reason, the benzene is more stable, and of course it undergoes substitution reaction, and there are mesomerism and resonance. So resonance means it may involves in all types of electron displacement. So in the case of resonance, any type of displacement of electron along the covalent bonded compound, that is called resonance. But in the case of mesomerism, where the multiple bonds are involved, in that multiple bond the delocalization displacement will take place. So mesomerism is noticed in only in those molecules which have multiple bonds. For example, here you can see that acetic acid or ethanoic acid, how these electrons are displaced, and here in this case is only, there is no need of multiple bonding system. And let me make it very clear, when we are saying cyclic bond, for example, this is cyclohexane. This cyclohexane is without pi electron. So this is aliphatic, it is called alicyclic. Ali stands for aliphatic and that is cyclic. It is called alicyclic. Even though it is not necessary that if any compound which is in ring form or cyclic form should be aromatic, it is aliphatic. And this one is aromatic because here pi electrons are moving. So this is the difference in aromatic character, aromatic compound, and alicyclic compound. Alicyclic compounds are the ring formed by aliphatic carbon atom. Thank you very much.